for, even if they're international players.
Yes, very true. So we are going to start off with a tree. Uyu's Uyu coming up to the stage here, recently sponsored, one of the newer sponsors on the Uyu team.
Damn, she's got a stick caddy?
You have a stick caddy?
Yeah.
Man, look, put you
do you
over
want me to
there.
Beat you, do you want me to beat you with the putter or the five iron?
It's like, man, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, where's my stick caddy?
Yeah, Yu's been coming to a couple of U.S. events. I remember from Combo Breaker. I don't remember if she went to CEO, but she's had a little bit of mixed success. I think a lot of the foreign players, the first time they start attending U.S. events, they kind of like, you know, they got to find their footing their first couple events, but definitely very strong Ling Xiaoyu player. One of the best female players in Japan, you know, Tanukana as well, Kobore. There's a lot of pretty good female players in Japan.
Yes, very much so. And on top of which, Yuyu really has had a lot of fame in Japan before Tekken 7 and has recently been sponsored. So she's finding her way around. I remember early on when Dimebag got into going into the Tekken World Tour on the States side, he was really nervous early on too.
Yeah.
And he was kind of struggling, and everybody was surprised with that. But since then has got sponsored by Equinox, has felt a lot more comfortable, and is doing really good on the Tekken World Tour. So maybe the same trajectory for someone like Yuyu. But don't count her out. She's an extremely strong player, and she might have found her stride right here at EVO 2018.
Yeah, I guess her big thing in the spotlight for Tekken 7 was that Kimono Michi set against Tanukana that went the distance 10-9.
Oh, yeah.
You really saw the difference in the styles between them. Tanukana being known for being a very aggressive kind of player. Yuyu, in general, tends to be more of a defensive Ling. And it's really interesting seeing that style, because a lot of the Ling players in general tend to favor that aggressive style. So seeing someone be super defensive, stay back, opt for more of the whiff punishing, block punishing style, really using Ling's evasiveness more of a defensive tool than an offensive one.
And would you say that's something that comes from her stint in Tekken, like how long she's been playing? Or is that something that is more of just her style in general? Like, as someone who's new to Tekken 7, is that something that other old Ling's had to do, or is that something that's just the way that she plays?
I've definitely seen, as long as Ling has been out, to be fair, Ling hasn't been good, like super good, for a really long time. This is her best version since, I'm going to say, Tekken 4. Mm-hmm. So as a worse character in previous games, Tekken 5, Tekken 6, to an extent, Tag 2, you definitely... There's always been that kind of difference in style. Even in the U.S., the older Ling players, such as Ling Massacre, JT, Geo, also had that kind of difference in style. Ling Massacre, in particular, being very aggressive and mix-up heavy.
Right.
Someone like Geo definitely favoring more of the defensive style. So I feel like as long as Ling has been out, there's always been that kind of split in style.
Okay.
So, and it's really interesting seeing that a character like Ling that can be played two different ways. I think a lot of characters like that Eddie. You see a lot of aggressive Eddies, but then you'll see somebody like Spirogen who plays that super turtly style Eddie as well, or Jun Ding as well.
Yes.
So it's really interesting seeing how a lot of characters in Tekken can bring out expression. You can play the same character two completely different ways.
I think that's super cool, and it really goes to show how strong a tool set is when you can play it in multiple different ways.
Yeah.
And I think the expression that comes from playing that game and it really shines in your character is one of the cooler things about Tekken.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I think personally, when you think about characters like Eddie and like Ling, you really think about those like really aggressive, like mid-crushing options, things that like really like able to get into people's faces and constantly put mix-ups. So when you say something like Yuyu is a defensive Ling, it sort of raises an eyebrow.
Yeah.
Even for someone like me who has like been basically watching the likes of like P-Ling and Tanukana, very aggressive style players who are constantly putting the mix-up on.
Yeah, I believe the kids referred to today as the mix.
The
they want to put you in the mix. I think that's what they say.
Yeah, that's what the kids say.
I don't know if they also say the terms like lit and turnt.
Yeah.
I'm not up on my vernacular with the young kids. I'm in my 30s. don't let the baby face fool you, but
I personally like the turntlings.
Yeah.
Those are my favorite.
Yeah, they're definitely more entertaining, but we're going to see how Yuyu plays fares here. We have a bunch of more players in this pool. I think coming up right after this, we're going to see Millennium Genius coming up, Paul player from France. Basically, there's three heavy hitters from Europe this year. Mm-hmm. Genius that we're going to see soon, Super Akuma that I believe played earlier today, and Fergus. I believe Super Akuma and Fergus both made it out of their pool in winners.
Yes.
So I'm interested to see. Genius has definitely played the longest. His first claim to fame was... If you see that picture of him playing Rip in Tekken 6, that inspired a lot of Twitch emotes and such.
Yeah.
But very strong Paul player. Mm. He's going to be playing Spoodler from Canada. As you said before, we're going to have people like Magnificent, Weapon X, yep. other people. So it's definitely going to be a good last set of pools to watch. But these guys are waiting to start. Yuyu is standing there. Maybe she wishes to swap out the putter for the long shot. Oh, I don't know how the wind is favoring her. She definitely wants, when she's playing Poochie from Texas, she definitely wants to make it on the green.
Yep, definitely.
I don't know how long I'm going to take this golf metaphor.
Take it all the way. Where's my caddy? I need a drink here. Yeah. That's what caddies do. They do more than just like take the sticks, right? They're also fetch me drinks, fan me during the game.
Dude, if I had somebody just come and fan me.
Yeah, fan me. Man, you know how baller that would be? Yeah. I'm going to just pay someone just to do it just because. Like, you need to go to your first round of your pool, and you're just going to have someone come up next to you and just fan you a little bit.
We're going to have CEO. We have CEO with the wrestling ring. When are we going to have a tournament with a boxing ring where in between games, people go to the corners, and they just have, like, seconds?
That'd be great. You put the stick down, you roll to the corner, you sit down,
just the ice pack, But these guys are getting started here.
You're doing great in the corner, Stevie. You just got to get them in there more often. But hit them with the hooks.
Yuyu, I don't think we're going to see anything except Ling out of her. We're going to see what Poochie from Texas plays. I mean, Texas is a big place. San Antonio, Dallas, Austin all have their own little sort of centers of Tekken, so we don't know exactly where he's from. So we'll see what character he brings out against the Ling. Yuyu going with the Zhao. No surprises there.
Yeah, hovering over the Claudio and maybe going for a repeat of last year.
Claudio not the worst choice against Ling.
No.
You have that hop kick to deal with AOP. Okay, locks in the Claudio.
Yeah, the hop kick deals with it quite well, on top of which has just a good idea of how to, you know, break down the game. Also, the knees do very well as well. Yeah. Scoops up off the ground.
Yeah, but, you know, if the hop kicks come out too many times against AOP, I can perfectly expect Yuyu to just sort of seal that option up. I mean, it is a good part of her game, but she definitely doesn't need to overly rely on it. Mm-hmm. So we'll see if there's an adjustment made here.
Yeah, I think it's really going to come down to not the hop kicks and how Yuyu gets around it, but rather how Poochie deals with the mix-ups as she gets in, right? And as a defensive player, it really is about converting, you know, block punishes and defensive options into mix-ups like that. You start off with the diving Falcon and already have the wall pressure.
Yeah, so they have the wall to their right side for Claudio. All right, so the hop kick there trying to challenge something. Nice duck on the string. All right, Poochie just going a little bit ham with the hop kicks there.
Yeah, that's what I was talking about right there. Block punish into the mix-up, goes back to Stormy Flower twice in a row, takes the first one. Round two. I'm going to assume we have the name switch. That was the first one going to Yuyu, gets the counter hit.
All right, again, two hits right from the start. You know, you could be defensive, but if you're going to hand me the hit on the platter, she's going to take it. And Yuyu looking super strong right now, full combo, back turn. Poochie trying not to be perturbed. Ling has her back to the wall. Oh, wow, Superman punch.
And in rage too, that did a chunk of damage, but shooting star gonna take it two rounds.
It's a quick two rounds for Yuyu. All right, breaks the 1+2 throw. Nice duck under to the running two. Nice sidestep. All right, modified combo. Ooh, get back four, hit AOP as well.
Yeah, looking for that back four too, safe mid string, just to get some room. Loses the mix up, but keeps on the pressure here. Oof. And that's gonna be the first game going to Yuyu.
An instant character select, man. The Claudio got washed.
I think maybe tried to go for a little bit of that beautiful dude tech. King of Iron Fist tournament. different players. Doesn't work out the same way.
Goes for Geese.
To the Geese. Geese, actually, a lot of people have been talking about how he's not Battle Vault character versus Ling because of that back three and the down four.
Yeah, back three is really good at checking AOP.
Yeah, and it's safe, so you really don't have that much worry in terms of just throwing it out, right?
Yeah, and when Poochie switched to that Geese, you saw Yu sort of like look. There's a little bit of a sigh there, a little bit of a rolling of the eyes. This character can be a problem.
These 2D characters. I can't believe these 2D characters in my game.
Yeah.
This is not the boxing I know.
But we move to Sook as a stage here.
Yeah, good for both characters. Geese has a very strong wall game, but yeah. Nice pickup on the side of Yu-Yu.
Yeah, Yu-Yu's been consistently converting off these floaters. Ooh, interesting.
Nice, gets the duck off under the 4-3.
Yeah, Yu-Yu backing up. She's got the life lead, doesn't really have to commit to anything.
Oh, right. Finish the string.
Nice block, nice hop kick.
Saw how early she was ducking there. Ducked the palm, in fact. Yeah. Yu-Yu takes the first round.
She seems ready for this Geese, though. Ooh, but back through two. Ooh, orbital counter hit. This does so much damage.
Nice carry, Stormy. Too.
All right, goes for a mix-up instead.
Nice.
Yeah, hit this four.
Counter. What a sidewall combo. Yu-Yu, that was fantastic. Put Poochie just inside of range.
Our blocks this time. Yeah, that is minus 15, but Ling's hop kick, not the best range.
Wasn't able to get the OTG grab after the stomp. Yu-Yu still has a healthy life here. Oh, 1-1-2 after the launch.
What was that combo, Poochie?
Oh, that's what he needed in order to get this started, but Yu-Yu now at set point. Fight.
Yeah, Yu-Yu looking super clean here. Doesn't break the 1+2 throw, though. That gives Geese a chunk of meter, like a third.
Yeah, it is definitely something Geese has looked to for that reason. But Max Mode, unfortunately, not capitalized on. Oh, back turn hop kick.
This is going to be, yeah, just short of the wall.
Just scoots out of there while running one on the air, gets the full damage on the wall.
Oh, disco for 1-1-2.
Oh man, the mix-up.
Firecracker, doesn't move, but nice punish on the get-up four.
That's gonna be the game and the set for Yu-Yu.
Yeah, Yu-Yu just playing super clean there, capitalizing on a lot of float combos, punishing correctly.
Yes.
I mean, she had the right read on that palm, like I said, but the hop kick didn't want to hook her up. But she definitely seemed ready for the Geese. She seemed ready for the Claudio.
Yeah, actually, back when she got first sponsored by UIU, she came out to SoCal to play against a lot of the people in SoCal because we knew that we had a variety of characters and players who were playing all the different kinds of unique characters that she hadn't played, because before she got sponsored, she was just staying at home, taking care of her children. And before that, she really hadn't brushed up on all the new things about Tekken 7.
Yeah.
So she actually came down to SoCal to play against Geese players and Noctis players so that she could get an idea.